collective national heritage, so we can have the Nigeria of our dreams, where there will be light at all times. This message is brought to you by the Nigerian Television Authority, NTA.
The finals of the Men and Women African Cup of Nations. It's always frenetic. On days such as this, there are no tribes, no religion. Here, Nigerian warriors are out to represent, to show the skills that...
Select group of Nigerians resident in Senegal meet President Muhammadu Buhari on the sidelines of the International Forum on Peace and Security in Dakar. Abuja Carnival 2016 ends. Benue State Police Command confirmed release of kidnapped Radio Benue staff. Welcome to NTA Network News with me, Muhammad Kudu Abubakar. President Muhammadu Buhari has strongly admonished Nigerian elite to stop making expensive demands on the federal government. He stressed that should things be done the old way as they desire, the country will remain impoverished. This was when he granted audience to a select group of Nigerians residents in Senegal and Cote d'Ivoire on the sidelines of the International Forum on Peace and Security in Dakar. State House correspondent Adamu Sambo reports.
At the interactive session, President Muhammadu Buhari and the diaspora community exchanged views on the nation's fundamental problems and the concerted efforts being made towards the restoration of normalcy for sustainable growth and development of the country. President Muhammadu Buhari was emphatic that his administration is genuinely focused on correcting past mistakes by dismantling obstacles to national prosperity. He said after 1.5 years of a popular mandate anchored on change, his administration is surely on the right track to improve the nation's image by entrenching probity and accountability in governance. The problems, he however said, are so enormous that maximum cooperation of Nigerians, particularly the elite, will be needed.
Please reflect on the condition the country finds itself on whatever demands they are going to make, because it's very, very insensitive for us that are leading the government for people to make very, very expensive demands or pretend that things can be done as usual. They can't. They can't. We have no other country but Nigeria. We may as well stay and correct these human mistakes that have, some of which have become a culture, to make sure that we rehabilitate the country.
On the welfare of Nigerians in the diaspora, the president said the federal government will continue to improve good neighborliness and improve the negative perception about Nigerians abroad. Both the president of the Nigerian community in Cote d'Ivoire, Adebayo Yahaya, and his Senegalese counterpart, Osas Edegin, commended President Buhari for his bold and unflinching fight against corruption and urged him not to relent as Nigerians are praying for his success. The senior special assistant to the president on diaspora matters, Abiket Dabri Erewa, coordinated the meeting.
We find that Nigerians are doing great things, developing economies of other countries. I believe that especially at this challenging time, Nigerians in the diaspora can play a major role.
It's been quite positive to see the quality of Nigerians in the diaspora, the quality of the work, the quality of the businesses they manage, and the way they have settled and integrated with their host communities.
And I think these people can be of good assets to us, and they seem to be good ambassadors of Nigeria, all in a kind of support to Mr. President.
The meeting with Nigerians was part of activities marking President Buhari's first official visit to Senegal. From Dakar, Senegal, Adamu Sambo, NTA News.
The two-day visit to the ECOWAS institutions by the chair of the Authority of Heads of State and Government Liberia's President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf has ended. Addressing journalists at the end of the visit, President Sirleaf noted with satisfaction, pointing out that the visit has enabled her to understand better the workings and challenges faced by the ECOWAS institutions. She reiterated the need for greater synergy between the organs and the institutions and called for prudence in managing scarce resources.
Will enhance the financial stability of the institution. So all of our commitments to go out there and make sure that these resources are mobilized in order that the work of the commission can go on as it has done over these many years.
The ECOWAS chair also spoke on efforts to bring peace to the troubled Guinea-Bissau.
When we come to the summit on the 17th, I hope there can be a meeting of all the heads of states to take a decision that we all can live with. But like I say, it's a very complicated situation, and it has been for the past 3 or 4 years.
President Sirleaf has since left Nigeria. The Senate has received President Muhammadu Buhari's official letter requesting to present the 2017 budget proposals at a joint session of the National Assembly. National Assembly correspondent Wazir Zayano reports that the budget presentation is expected to hold on Wednesday, the 14th of December.
Senate President Bukola Saraki read the President's letter of requests.
I crave the kind indulgence of the National Assembly to grant me the slot of 10:00 hours on Wednesday, the 14th of December, 2016, to formally address a joint session of the National Assembly.
Aside from a few reports laid, continued deliberation on the INEC bill took the entire day's plenary, with the senators being thorough and trying to x-ray all intricate and difficult aspects.
Political parties seeking to nominate candidates for elections under this act shall hold direct or indirect primaries for aspirants.
There are some political parties that are so insolvent that are going to a national daily to publish primaries. Yeah, continuously will be impossible for them.
We should, as much as possible, try to, provide the necessary guidelines that will enhance the credibility and transparency of the conduct of political party.
If you are talking about holding that primaries in the Tarsi states, it shouldn't hold in one particular day. That's where confusion comes in.
At the end of the plenary, the committee on INEC was given 24 hours to harmonize contributions and put things into proper perspectives.
24 hours to look at this item and bring it back so that we can put it in the other paper and try and finish it as soon as possible.
Outside plenary, the Senate Committee on Tertiary Institutions and Debt Fund held a public hearing on the Federal Polytechnic Act Amendment Bill 2016. The bill intended to provide for the inclusion of 9 recently created federal polytechnics, as well as review retirement age of staff of the federal polytechnic.
I am sure that if we get it right, these bills will help improve the quality of our education.
It is expected that at the end of the exercise, we will leave here fulfilled that the outcome of our contributions will bring about sustainable change for our people.
From the National Assembly, Wazir Zayan, NTA News.
Still at the National Assembly, the House of Representatives has passed a second reading, a bill for an act to separate the office of the Attorney General of the Federation from that of the Minister of Justice. Members at Tuesday's plenary also adopted the Conference Committee report on environment in the 2016 budget. Also tendered is a request from President Muhammadu Buhari to present the 2017 budget proposal before a joint session of the National Assembly. Ignatius Nko has the reports.
Plenary commenced with Speaker Yakubu Dogara reading the communication from President Muhammadu Buhari requesting approval to present the 2017 budget before the National Assembly.
To grant me the slot of 10 o'clock on Wednesday, 14th December 2016, to formally address a joint session of the National Assembly on the 2017 budget proposal and our plans to get the country out of recession.
A bill for an act to separate the office of the Attorney General of the Federation from that of the Minister of Justice, sponsored by Representative Mohammed Mungano from Borno State, was passed at second reading.
It is therefore necessary to insulate that office from the vagaries and vicissitudes of political influence.
A bill for an act to provide for the establishment of the Ecclesiastical Court of Appeal of the Federal Capital Territory and that 6 days of the Federation, sponsored by Representative Estefanus Giang from Plateau State and 8 others, also passed a second reading. The House adopted a motion for the House to investigate the 30% export expansion grant of the federal government, moved by Representative Sadiq Ibrahim from Adamawa State, and that by Representative Aishatu Doku from Gombe State, mandating the House Committee on Petroleum Resources Downstream to find out why construction works at the Petroleum College, Kaduna, was suspended. Members resolved to investigate the circumstance that led to the death of a core member, Rachel Oladebo, at the NYSC orientation camp, Kano, by inviting the Director General of the NYSC to appear before the House Joint Committees on Youth, Justice and Healthcare Services.
But I don't want our death to be in vain.
That adequate facilities need to be put in orientation camps.
The medical attendants were negligent.
The House observed a minute silence to honor the late core member and others who died in similar circumstances, as moved by Representative Olufemi Fakaye from Osun State. A motion on the need for dredging of Omambala River in Anambra State was adopted, as moved by Representative Tony Woye from the state. From the National Assembly, Ignatius Nkwo, NTA News.
Vice President Yemi Osinbajo says the Buhari administration is addressing the remote and immediate causes of the economic hardship by Nigerians. He stated this at the grassroots town hall meeting in Kano. Abdullahi Mustafa reports.
The grassroots town hall meeting is a platform that brought together small-scale entrepreneurs. It was to exchange ideas on how to effectively address the challenges militating against the growth of small and medium businesses. Some of the contributions were on how soon the economic hardship being experienced could be brought to an end. Vice President Yemi Osinbajo attributed the economic recession to corruption. He said President Muhammadu Buhari is committed to addressing the daunting challenge, as his administration is also working towards diversifying the nation's economy. Governor Abdullahi Umar Ganduje, who acknowledged the positive changes witnessed during the last 1.5 years of President Muhammadu Buhari's stewardship, said Kano State Government has already responded to his call for the revitalization of agriculture.
His Excellency, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Muhammadu Buhari, has already told us to look inwards.
Minister of Women Affairs Aisha Jumai Al-Hassan and her trade and investment counterpart Okechukwu Enelama highlighted the modalities for accessing the numerous opportunities the federal government has provided for Nigerian women and youth. In Kano, Abdullahi Mustafa, NTA News.
President Muhammadu Buhari has again reiterated his administration's determination to use tourism as a vehicle to drive economic growth and wealth creation. He stated this in a message to a special command performance as part of the activities for the 2016 Abuja Carnival. Anthony Folsom reports.
Muhammadu Buhari, while reaffirming the strategic role culture and tourism can play, assured that his administration will ensure that the sector is provided the enabling environment to thrive. President Muhammadu Buhari was represented by the Minister of Federal Capital Territory, Mohammed Musa Bello, at the special command performance.
The issue of economic growth, which is the primary focus of this event, is one of the central issues of the change agenda of this administration.
On his part, Information and Culture Minister Lai Mohammed amplified the role of the creative industry in an economy in recession.
The creative industry is that low-hanging fruit that the drug and others to gradually come out of recession.
Aside from performances by Nigerian groups, there was a special performance by a Nigerian group from the Korean Embassy. In Abuja, Anthony Forson, NTA News.
The just concluded Abuja Carnival has been described as one of the many potent platforms to showcase Nigeria's rich cultural heritage. Vice President Yemi Osinbajo stated these in a message to the closing ceremony of the 2016 Abuja Carnival. Here again is Anthony Forson.
Vice President Yemi Osinbajo, who was represented by Senator Babafemi Ojudu, maintained that the federal government is desirous in moving the creative industry to an enviable height for the nation's youths to develop their talents in a positive manner. He said, with the display of mastery and complete grasp of the creative industry at the just concluded fiesta by participants from across the country, the abundant talent they showcased is a testimony to the fact that the sector is viable.
What you have done has shown that Nigeria is bound for the heights. You are already opening our eyes to the possibilities of so much that we can do with our cultures in the area of diversifying our economy.
Information and Culture Minister Lai Mohammed had earlier congratulated the organizers and the participating states for their show of competence and dedication in wanting to heed the federal government's moves to make the sector a lucrative one.
Nigeria, as we all know, is endowed with diverse cultural heritage and a thriving multi-sectoral creative industry, which is a key contributor to economic growth.
In the end, Kogi State emerged overall winner as other states equally picked prizes in the various groupings. The Abuja Carnival was created to provide a unique brand for the 36 states and the Federal Capital Territory to come together and promote unity and diversity amongst the people and further strengthen the mutual bond as a country. In Abuja, Anthony Forson, NTA News.
In fulfillment of the assurances to assist Nigeria develop its tourism master plan, the International Tourism Advisor to the United Nations World Tourism Organization, Jim Flannery, has arrived in Nigeria. Anthony Forson reports that Information and Culture Minister Lai Mohammed received Jim Flannery in his office in Abuja.
Flannery, while extending views with the minister, said, contrary to expectations to review the Nigeria Tourism Master Plan, the document, he said, is perfect and captures all that is needed to be captured. Its delay in implementation was what hampered it. He said what he has come to do is to fast track the takeoff of the implementation.
Let's identify things which can be done quickly to show that we can do the things and show that we can create new products, we can open new markets.
He said what he has come to do is to fast track the takeoff of the implementation of the master plan for optimal results. Expressing satisfaction with Jim Flannery's submission, the Information and Culture Minister said the United Nations World Tourism Organization has lived up to its words, a testimony that with tourism, Nigeria can grow its economy and create direct jobs for its teeming population.
It's the first concrete evidence that yes, truly, all that I say we were able to achieve and our July meeting with UNWTO is true, and that's why I'm particularly glad.
He assured that all impediments to slow the process will be fast-tracked, especially in the country's visa regime policy. The cheering news the minister unveiled is that another group will trail Jim Flannery's visit. That group, he said, will stay for upward of 1 year, training and building capacity for tourism in Nigeria. In Abuja, Anthony Forson, NTA News.
Reports just reaching us says President Muhammadu Buhari has assured the international community that the end of Boko Haram terrorists is in sight, even as he held increased cooperation between Nigeria and its neighbors in the fight against terrorism. He stated these while contributing to a panel of heads of state at the third Dakar International Forum on Peace and Security in Africa. The president also assured that the security situation in Nigeria had improved significantly. President Buhari spoke with the president of Chad and expressed satisfaction that the number of Chadians and Nigerians that were Boko Haram members are surrendering en masse. President Buhari also explained that the multinational joint task force is in their respective position and at a designated time they will move simultaneously and spontaneously to see the end of Boko Haram. Highlighting the gains of the cooperation among the Lake Chad Basin Commission countries comprising Chad, Niger, Cameroon, Benin Republic, and Nigeria, the Nigerian leader told the gathering that terrorists are no longer holding any territory or local government area in Nigeria. He noted that Nigeria is capable of surmounting its security challenges and appealed to the international community to focus more on attention on addressing piracy in the Gulf of Guinea and unemployment in Nigeria. The Buhari Media Support Group has described as uncharitable and baseless allegations by a former House of Representatives member, Dr. Junaidu Mohammed, that President Muhammadu Buhari exploited religion in 2015 to gain political advantage and power. Reacting to Dr. Junaidu's latest criticism of President Buhari, chairman of the group, Muhammad Labo, said the allegations are totally false and misleading because they didn't reflect the realities of the political career of General Buhari in 2003, 2007, 2011, and 2015. According to the statement, if Buhari was a religious bigot, he would not have repeatedly chosen Christians as his running mates and resisted the idea of a Muslim ticket. He also advised Dr. Junaidu Mohammed to respect facts and stop spreading falsehood to discredit and undermine the President Buhari, adding that as a respected medical doctor and public figure, he should be a role model for honor and truthfulness. Head of the Civil Service of the Federation, Winifred Oyo Ita, has reiterated federal government's irrevocable commitment to provide affordable houses for civil servants through the Federal Government Integrated Housing Program, FISH. Mrs. Oyo Ita stated this when she received an estate developer in Abuja. Adebola Brooklyn Sunday reports.
Standing on the vision of President Muhammadu Buhari in providing affordable housing for Nigerians, she noted that the provision of housing for Nigerians is one of the critical areas of intervention identified by the present administration, the reason for partnership with credible developers.
We are already discussing with the management of the Federal Mortgage Bank to provide mortgage loan facilities at a very, very reduced interest rate for civil servants.
We don't intend to reduce our quality, but we intend to reduce the price and make it affordable. The Federal Civil Service have offered to help us to bring down our cost of construction by getting involved in some process of the infrastructure.
Chairman of the FISH program and the Federal Government Staff Housing Loans Board, Yemi Adelakun, brief newsmen on behalf of the head of the Civil Service of the Federation.
The cost element that is very, very important in house, a delivery of affordable housing, is land. The head of service has written and spoken with the FCT minister to give us land, which is about 30% cost of the house price.
Record shows that over 8,000 civil servants have so far registered for the FISH program. Adebola, Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
The operational capacity of the Nigerian Navy fleet and its commands in safeguarding the nation's offshore oil installations was put to test during the Chief of Naval Staff annual sea inspection exercise. Defense correspondent Isaac Nkuma, who sailed on the Nigerian Navy ship Centenary, reports that some arrests were made during the exercise.
This year alone, the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation recorded 1,447 incidents of pipeline vandalism in 5 months. With the resurgence of attacks on oil and gas facilities in the Niger Delta, especially offshore platforms, the first line of defense is the Nigerian Navy. The annual Chief of Naval Staff Sea Exercise therefore provides a platform to evaluate combat readiness of its personnel and vessels in securing all national assets from the deep sea to shallow waters.
Indiscriminate attack on shipping were witnessed well into the first quarter of the year. The Nigerian Navy responded by constituting a task force to mount anti-piracy special operation, Operation Zareteku, which was instantly successful and has to be extended for initial month into a third flag of 9 cumulative months.
You've been able to see the
critical oil and gas infrastructure we have at sea there, which needs to be protected. You can only protect that by maintaining presence out there.
The exercise paid off with the arrest of two persons transporting barges suspected to be carrying stolen crude and handed over to the EFCC.
After sailing 156 nautical miles, this point, the Chevron oil facility at Agbami, marks the climax of the Chief of Naval Staff annual sea inspection for 2016, codenamed Exercise Eagle Eye. Isaac Nkuma, NTA News.
Transfer of military intelligence information, optimum capacity building, as well as strong bilateral relations have been identified as pivotal to counterinsurgency and the fight against terrorism. This was at a lecture to course 25 of the National Defense College by the Pakistani Chief of Air Staff, Air Chief Marshal Sohail Aman in Abuja. Olajide Bello reports.
In the lecture titled Pakistani Air Force Rule in the War of Terror, Air Chief Marshal Sohail Aman identified quick analysis and responses, precise engagement of targets as key in counterinsurgency operations.
And then draw your own lesson and see how can you fight the menace of terrorism.
The Commandant, National Defense College, Rear Admiral Samuel Aladi, emphasizing the importance of the lecture, says it will help the college build its knowledge base on the effective use of air power to enhance counterinsurgency operations in the country.
To cooperate in the area of law enforcement, particularly with regard to narcotic shipping.
The Chief of Air Staff, Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar, played host to the Pakistani Chief of Air Staff on a tactical brainstorming session to further enhance the air power and efficiency of the Nigerian Air Force.
This partnership, what we are looking at, just to identify other areas of partnership which we have, and I'm sure very soon we'll send our team there and their own people will also come here.
The chiefs reiterated their commitment to work closely in fighting terrorism and insurgency. In Abuja, Olajide Bello, NTA News.
You can watch this news live online via the NTA mobile app, which you can download on your Android device at the Google Play Store or at the Apple Store if you use devices with iOS. Quest for stability and national growth in Nigeria's federalism again in focus. These and more reports when NTA Network News returns. Don't go away.
This is a happy moment for me and for all Nigerians.
Amina Ali Nkeke, the first Chibok school girl to be rescued in the renewed onslaught against the Boko Haram insurgency.
Amina's rescue gives us new hope.
Federal government has formally received the 21 abducted Chibok girls.
These dear daughters of ours have seen the worst that the world has to offer. It is now time for them to experience the best that the world can do for them. Government will sustain the effort until all the remaining girls return safely.
Will show you how to save more in these tough times.
Wife's powder.
It's pretty good and money's tight.
But Ariel gives better cleaning with less powder.
Impossible.
Come with me.
Spaghetti sauce, chocolate drink. For these tough stains, I'll need one, two.
And just one handful of Ariel. New Ariel gives better stain removal with less powder.
That's real savings. Ariel removes tough stains better in one wash.
Hello?
Welcome to the M6 Challenge. Using your new Geely M6, carry out everything on that list, starting now. Congratulations, you have passed the test. Gioni M6 with a 5,000 milliamp battery that lets you go on for 2 days on a single charge. Gioni M6, always in power.
In our determined efforts to encourage the consumption of locally manufactured products and save the nation from becoming a dumping ground for substandard products, importation, sale and distribution of fruit juice made overseas would no longer be allowed in Nigerian markets with effect from 31st December 2016. In this vein, NAFDAC has been carrying out raids across the country to mop up the ones already illegally imported into the system. To make these a success, NAFDAC wishes to solicit the support and cooperation of the public to encourage the patronage of juices produced by our indigenous companies who have the installed capacity and technical know-how to satisfy the needs of the consumers. It is therefore an offense for anyone or company to engage in the importation, sale and distribution of foreign fruit juices with effect from 31st December 2016, as violators will be prosecuted. NAFDAC, safeguarding the health of the nation. Management announced. So.
Join me on the 7th of December 2016 at the International Conference Center Abuja as I flag off the EFCC Women Against Corruption project. Nigeria women, let us kill corruption before it kills us and our families. I am calling on all Nigerian women to come out en masse and join hands with the administration to fight corruption.
Nupeng PTD, in collaboration with FRSC, pleads with its members and other road users to be extra careful as Christmas and New Year festivities approach. Please take other road users into consideration and avoid situations that can lead to crashes. Also, be vigilant and careful around construction areas and obey all diversions and other road signs. Let's make 2017 a crash-free year as we avoid night journeys and maintain our vehicles. Otumba Salmon Akoni Oladiti, National Chairman, PTD of Nupeng, announcer.
Whenever pain occurs, you want quick relief. Try new Nurofen Express. It goes to the source of pain and gets to work in under 15 minutes. That's why Nurofen Express delivers fast and effective relief. New Nurofen Express works at the source of pain. Fast.
Being a mom is great, but when your child has a fever, you don't know what to do. I trust Nurofen for Children to take care of my child's pain and fever.
Effective relief you can trust.
The Senate Joint Committee on Petroleum Industry Governance Bill, PIGB, hereby invites stakeholders and the general public to a public hearing on the Petroleum Industry Governance Bill, date Wednesday 7th to Friday 9th December 2016, venue, conference room 0.22, Senate Building, National Assembly Complex, Abuja, time 10 a.m. daily. All memoranda should be forwarded to the clerk of the committee in room SB 46, White House, Senate Wing, National Assembly Complex, Abuja. The following institutions are expected to make submissions: Ministry of Petroleum Resources, Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, Department of Petroleum Resources, International Oil Companies, Nigerian Oil Companies, Petroleum Technology Development Fund, Civil Society Organizations, amongst others. Senator Omotayo Donald Alaso Adura, Chairman, announcer.
Hey, red hot promo. Only buff
if I win the 10 million naira, the kind correct thing we are going to arrange for you.
I go open two big shops. Now, you make me don't recharge plenty today. I even don't collect the deal of the day where Airtel give me today.
Charge. Not only once we are recharged now. That means that you get plenty chance to win fast.
You don't see anything we are getting. Let the two of us get
that.
Only buff. Wait a minute. Only buff. You want money another way?
Joke at the joke.
Now my name be that. I win 10 million! I win 10 million!
We don't win 10 million! We don't win 10 million!
You don't say the thing where you get. Now me and you get them now.
You sir! Now joke at the joke when I talk at that time.
Promo runs till end of January 2017. Airtel. Smartphone network.
You're still on to NTA Network News. Nigeria's federalism is evolving and it requires much commitment on the part of leadership and the led to attend the quest for stability and national growth. These were the views of speakers at a media luncheon by an African Policy Research Institute in Abuja. Abdullahi Garba Bernankudu reports.
From amalgamation in 1914 to the regional level and now to 36 states, Nigerian federalism experts believe is emerging. In a relaxed atmosphere, the 2 years' research documented in a book on Nigerian federalism and continued quest for stability and nation building was digested.
Where we are now, we have had some bad experiences that we need to drop off, but there are also some good elements that if we harness them well, we are able to build a viable nation.
In a society like Nigeria, with all its diversities, history has shown that such societies have done best, you know, if they are able to evolve a system that makes it possible to, on the one hand, be united, and on the other hand, also be separate and distinct.
To some, there is need for adjustment in the way federalism is being operated.
I believe the central government should be weakened to a point that it's not as powerful as the regions, or if we cannot go back to regions, go back to the states.
The book will soon be presented to the public. In Abuja, Abdullahi Gerba Brunokudu, NTA News.
Chairman House Committee on Insurance, Adekunle Akinlade, has assured the management of the NTA of a better insurance cover for staff and equipment. He said this when the committee visited the corporate headquarters of NTA in Abuja on an oversight. Adebola Brooksland Sunday reports.
The committee members were taken round on a guided tour of facilities, which include the high-definition studio, master control room before proceeding to Wonder Cube at the multi-channels. Chairman of the committee was briefed on the functionability of each equipment and the status of their insurance cover.
We will make sure that we provide full support. We're trying to create synergy with MDS in this regard to make sure that we create, you know, enabling environment for these organizations and institutions to work, you know, to perform maximally. And we know by doing that, of course, you know, it's going to be for the, you know, betterment of all of us. So if we look at these equipments and we're able to see where we could have to upgrade this equipment so that they can actually cover them adequately, we will be able to recommend.
The DG speaks on NTA's readiness for digital switchover.
The government is poised. Nigeria should transit by June of next year. And government is leaving no stones unturned to make sure that this objective is realized.
Members had earlier met with the management of the NTA, where the need for proper documentation leading to policy formulation was discussed extensively. Director General of the NTA, Yakubu Ibrahim Mohammed, thereafter assured that management will present a position paper to the committee soonest. Adebola, Brooksland Sunday, NTA News.
The federal government is to design a 3-year strategy for the sustenance of internally displaced persons across the country. The Federal Commissioner, National Commission for Refugees, Migrants and Internally Displaced Persons, Sadia Omar Farouk, stated this during a visit to one of the IDP camps in Makurdi. Achigile Magaji reports.
The strategy tagged Practical Durable Solution is to, among other things, set up the trainers camps across the country for skills acquisition to economically empower the people. The Federal Commissioner, High Commission for Refugees, Sadia Farouk, noted that the Commission is also committed to the return and reintegration of the IDPs in the country.
We intend to come up with that plan, that thereby giving them adequate housing and providing some kind of social amenities in collaboration with the state government and the federal government as well.
These materials and commodities you passed over to us here this afternoon will be very judiciously used and they will be directed specifically to the IDPs.
Some of the representatives of the displaced persons thanked the federal government for reaching out to them in that difficult moment. In Makurdi, Achigile Magaji, NTA News.
The Nigeria Police Force have arrested some suspects connected to the alleged damning misconduct at the internally displaced persons camp in the northeast. Inspector General of Police Ibrahim Idris, who announced this at the media at a meeting with top police senior police officers in Abuja, said some security personnel were involved. Edino Justice reports.
Details of the arrest, the IGP Ibrahim Idris said it was the finding of a panel he set up to investigate the allegation of official misconduct at the Northeast IDP camps. He said so far, two policemen, two civilian JTF, one prison officials, a civilian, and four military personnel have been fingered, noting that the policemen will be dismissed before charging them to court, while those from sister agencies will be handled by their respective formations.
We are putting a lot of measures to see how we can enhance training of our personnel who we are going to attach to this, some of these IDPs.
On the forthcoming Rivers State rerun election, the IGP said everything is being done to achieve a violence-free election. Ibrahim Idris also affirmed that police have evolved new measures for quick payment of all allowances. The conference also featured the decoration of the newly promoted senior officers. Among them is Mr. Valentine Tochuku, Deputy Inspector General of Police, and four new commissioners, Edina Justice, NTA News.
The Benue State Police Command has confirmed the release of Mrs. Iyadu Tuagbede, a staff of the Radio Benue, who was abducted by the unknown gunmen in the early hours of Friday last week. Police Public Relations Officer for Benue State Command, Joel Yamu, announced that the network of intelligence and swift action of the security agents resulted in the release of the victim. Charles Abba reports.
The unknown gunmen were said to have bumped into the Makudi residence of Mrs. Iyuado Toagwidie, a news editor of Radio Benue Makudi, Benue State, in the early hours of Friday last week and abducted her. She was, however, released unharmed late in the night on Monday and has reunited with her family. Police Public Relations Officer of the Benue State Police Command, Joe Yamu, who confirmed her release, said two suspects have been arrested in connection with the abduction and that the police is trailing the principal suspect.
We are working on tracking whoever is behind the camera. Very soon we are going to make a breakthrough.
Because they tied my face, I didn't know whether it was bright. But we went for hours, took me, handed me over to a man, but my eyes were tied.
The PPRO solicited useful information from members of the public and urged them to be more security conscious, especially this coming festive period. In Makudi, Charles Abba, NTA News.
The Federal High Court in Lagos sentences a drug trafficker. Let's get details from Vera in our NTA Lagos Network Center. Hello, Vera. Take it over from here.
Thank you very much, Kudu. Good evening. This is Lagos. The Federal High Court, sitting in Lagos, has sentenced a 53-year-old man, Yinka Ogunshola, to a term of 2 years imprisonment for drug trafficking. He was arrested on the 11th of June with 600 grams of cannabis, popularly known as Indian hemp. The convict, Yinka Ogunshola, a tailor, was charged by the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, NDLA, on a one-count charge for dealing in restricted narcotics. He was first arraigned on the 11th of June and had pleaded not guilty to the charge. However, at the resumed hearing, the accused requested to change his plea. Following his request, he was rearraigned and he pleaded guilty. The prosecutor, Jeremiah Amon, reviewed the first of the case and tendered several evidence, including a written statement of the accused, a request for scientific aid and drug analysis forms, which the court admitted as exhibits. In her judgment, Justice Oluremi Oguntoyinbo found the accused guilty as charged and accordingly convicted him to a term of 2 years imprisonment, beginning from the date of his arrest. She also ordered the remnants of the drugs to be destroyed by the NDLA within 90 days if no appeal is filed against the judgment. The Nigerian Navy has restated its commitment to protecting the nation's maritime domain for better service delivery. The Flag Officer Commanding Western Naval Command, Rear Admiral Ferguson Bobai, stated this when the Senate Committee on Navy visit the Western Naval Command at Papa Lagos as part of its oversight function. Ken Igbelewe has details.
The role of the Nigerian Navy in combating all forms of criminal activities in the nation's maritime domain cannot be overemphasized. This is because, apart from carrying out our statutory responsibility of protecting the nation's territorial waters, she also helps in the economic development of the nation by protecting the wealth of the country through the sea. In order to perform this role effectively, the Nigerian Navy requires adequate and modern patrol vessels that will be deployed to the IC, particularly in the Gulf of Guinea. The visit of the Senate Committee on Navy to Western Naval Command is to acquaint the Navy on the operational activities of the command, challenges, and the need to provide support for the Navy through budgeting allocation. Members of the committee, we are taking on tour of facilities at the base.
We are going to do as a committee to make sure that this time around the Navy has so much resources that they can perform this duty. And I'm sure if these resources are given, these activities of militants and other things in the Niger Delta, it will reduce.
The flag officer commanding Western Naval Command told the committee that manpower development remains a challenge to the Navy.
We are looking at possibilities of training, if they could get us more funds so that we'll be able to do all these things, motivate us so that we'll be able to do what, put vessels out to sea.
The committee also inspected formations at the Naval Training Command in Apapa in Lagos. Ken Egbeluge, NTA News.
And if you're just joining us, you're watching the NTA Network News live from the Lagos Network Center. We have more reports ahead on the news, but first, after this time out.
This must be one of Mother Nature's greatest gifts. But there's something else it gives us. When we see such beauty, we want to share it with those we love. That's what LG wants you to see. Just what we see now, through our technology. LG OLED TV.
My daughter, you are a star. May you be the secret ingredient that makes a happy home.
Maggie Star, made from natural soybeans and other carefully selected ingredients, prepared in a way only Maggie knows. That's why for generations, Maggie Star has been the secret that brings out the rich taste and aroma in local soups. With Maggie, every woman is a star.
Nestle, good food, good.
Milliampere battery that lets you play for up to 3 days on a single charge. Geoni M5 Plus, always in power.
It's truck month at Ford, and we've got a Ranger just for you, Vincent. Here's the Workhorse 2.5 petrol single cab with free Ford Protect, a 4-year 120,000 kilometer service plan, or the 2.5 petrol based double cab with 800 millimeter water wading capability, available in manual transmission and with free Ford Protect. So, while stocks last, visit Koscharis Motors today. Because, wait for it, thanks, Vincent. We've got a tough Ford Ranger just for you.
Thank you for remaining with NTN Network News. Nigeria bans importation of vehicles through the land borders. For these and other reports on the economy, let's join Moplan Dakok on Business News.
It's a pleasure to have you join us on Business News. Producing, patronizing, and consuming made in Nigeria goods is the surest way of making the country and its citizens survive the current economic situation. Minister of Budget and National Planning, Udoma Udo Udoma, said this focus cannot be overemphasized.
We want to rapidly expand in terms of manufacturing, which is why we are supporting a Made in Nigeria campaign. We want to support the expansion of export processing zones. We want, because they provide even more employment.
The Central Bank of Nigeria has organized a special foreign exchange auction aimed at meeting a backlog of demand by fuel importers. Governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Godwin Emefiele, requested banks to submit bids for the currency auction to meet demand for matured letters of credit. And the federal government has banned the importation of vehicles into Nigeria through the land borders. A statement by the Public Relations Officer of Customs, Wole Adeniyi, indicates that the prohibition order covers all new and used vehicles. And for some market activities, the Nigerian Stock Exchange closed on a negative note Tuesday as the All Share Index depreciated by minus 0.28%. That's business news at this time. I am Moplan Dakok.
Thank you, Moplan. As part of efforts to provide world-class aviation services to its numerous customers, Azman Air has procured additional Boeing 737-500 series to its fleet. Mansour Aliyu Hassan reports that the formal launching of the aircraft attracted personalities from across the country.
Azman Air commenced airline operations on the 15th of May 2014 with two aircrafts. 2 years later, the indigenous airline size was expanded to three, shuttling through all the nation's airports and eight West African countries, in addition to flying to Saudi Arabia, Dubai and China. The newly procured Boeing 737-500 series with the registration number 5NAIS landed at the Malam Amini Kano International Airport at exactly 5:17 p.m. directly from London. The 108-capacity jet has been certified by all the international, regional and local aviation authorities to fly to any part of the world.
I can go to any route. I can go to domestic, I can go to regional and go to international. Very soon we are going to start going to Saudi Arabia by this aircraft.
So we have the capacity to operate all the routes in Nigeria now.
Governor Abdullahi Umar Ganduje and Emir of Kano Muhammad Sanusi II were among the dignitaries at the formal luncheon of the branded Azman aircraft.
The relationship between Kano State Government and the company of Azman has grown from strength to strength. And
Azman Air is a 100% indigenous airline that has over 500 Nigerians on its payroll. Mansour Aliyu Hassan, NTA News.
Revenue generation should not be the priority of road safety management agencies. The focus should rather be on the safety of road users. Co-Marshal Federal Road Safety Commission Boboye Oyemi stated this at the maiden meeting with Nigeria's heads of state traffic agencies in Abuja. Olayinka Ojo reports.
Is against the background of activation of the Nigerian Road Safety Strategy, a response to two global events. Explaining that road safety is the responsibility of everyone, FRSC Co-Marshal Boboye Oyemi urged heads of state traffic agencies to always respond swiftly to road accidents, as well as caution road users who violate traffic rules. While reiterating that fines regime is a necessary instrument for curtailing road traffic excesses, the FRSC boss said traffic management agencies and road safety corps must create a robust cooperation mechanism.
We have 204,000 kilometers of road network in Nigeria. Federal roads is just about 35. There's no way FRSC alone can cover that road network, so the states must play their role.
Responding on behalf of state traffic agencies, Managing Director, Kano Road and Traffic Agency, Mohammed Hadi Zarowa said.
We know our challenges, we know what we are coming across. So definitely this our discussion is going to be a forum for how can we improve of, what is happening.
Out of 36 states of the Federation, 16 states have established traffic management agencies. In Abuja, Olainka Ojo, NTA News.
Time now for another break. When we return, global tidbits, sports update, and weather forecast are next. Stay with the NTA.
Look at the creative industry for employment creation and wealth generation is the focus on NTA Tuesday Live this week, highlighting and interrogating the vast array of Nigeria's arts, culture, and tradition only on NTA Tuesday Live. Tuesday Live, educative, informative, and enlightening. Don't be told. Join us.
Hi, guys. Look how my baby Jamil has grown. And as they grow, there's a worry we all share, skin rash. Some use lotions or petroleum jelly, but I found what works for Jamil is Nigerian Pampers. It has built-in lotion to help protect his delicate skin and keep him dry. See you in the morning, Jam Jam. Good morning, happy Jam Jam. Dry and soft and no sign of a rash. Join many other moms and try Nigerian Pampers with lotion. Let's beat the rash.
Nigeria joins the rest of the world in going digital. This means Nigeria is moving from analog terrestrial TV broadcasting to digital. Now, digital broadcasting gives you clearer pictures, crystal clear sound, and a chance for more channels and more shows to watch. Digital TV is a whole new experience for you and a rich harvest of digital devotees for the nation. Come aboard, Nigeria.
Some water? It's cold, especially for you.
Which era are you living in? We have a fridge.
When everything else in your house is from the present, then why are your toilet cleaning methods from the past? Hapik, all in one for you. Compared to other toilet cleaners, Hapik removes top stains, kills all germs, and removes bad odors for a shining clean and fresh toilet.
Wow.
You should also take the Hapik
all-in-one challenge.
Oku Ekpeyong is here with Global Tidbits.
Lord's Resistance Army Commander Dominic Unwin is the first child soldier to be tried by the International Criminal Court in The Hague. He faces 70 counts of war crimes and crimes against humanity in Uganda, more charges than any other suspect. Dominic Unwin was a boy of 10 when he was abducted and conscripted by the notoriously ruthless rebel cult.
Now, Ayodeji Makinde is here with sport updates.
Food Radio Corporation of Nigeria in Abuja, Tuesday. Chairman, League Management Company Shehu Diko says the radio coverage of the competition with effect from the forthcoming 2016-2017 season will raise the standard and followership of the league amongst Nigerians.
We are now signing an agreement with them to take back our football back to the people. The people own this game. This is the public trust we run, and everybody should be involved. Everybody should be able to know what's going on here. And there's no any other platform to get that done as quickly as possible than the radio.
Group stage.
Political agency, I am Blessing Agambi. It is the time of the year where we experience warmer daytime temperatures and cooler nights. And so for Wednesday, we expect these conditions to still prevail. Be sure to enjoy your midweek activities. As we anticipate, dust days over the northern parts of the country, while the central states will be sunny and hazy. Other parts of the country will be cloudy to partly cloudy in the morning hours later in the day. Cloudiness over the southern parts of the country is expected to give rise to isolated thunderstorms over parts of Akwa Ibom, Calabar, Delta State, the coast of Ondo State, and parts of Ijebu-Ode. And that's it from the Nigerian Meteorological Agency. See you again.
And that concludes NTA Network News for tonight. Thank you for watching. Good night.